Preparations are in high gear for the Nana Line movement, NAM, and the G77 summits, which are to be held in the country early next year. The head of public service, Lucina Chiobe, has maintained that the successful hosting of these summits will greatly benefit the country.
I want to assure you all that the country is secure to receive the international visitors coming in January, and everything is ready, and we are ready for our guests. But I still call upon the general public to continue the vigilance to keep the security tight.
However, more funds are still needed to make the preparations a success, and they have a budget of 66 billion shillings. The NAM Summit will be the biggest conference to be held in the country after the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting, or CHOGAM, which was held in 2007. Nachobia's father highlighted on how the visitors will be transported.
Transport and vehicles for the summit. The government has mobilized the requisite vehicles for the two summits. And in addition, the People's Republic of China earlier had donated 70 SUVs and added us another 70 SUVs. And these are already here with us in the country for use at the summits.
Never before have we hosted the number of delegates we are expecting. The last major international conferences organized were the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting in 2007 and the African Union Summit in 2010, both of which had over 50 member states. For the two summits in January, we expect to receive delegations from about 145 countries, comprising member states of non-aligned movement and a group of 77 plus China.
The Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of ICT, Dr. Amina Zawede, gave assurance that the internet connectivity will be very efficient during the summit, adding that the internet at Entebbe Airport has been upgraded.
We have been able to upgrade our Wi-Fi at the airport to Wi-Fi 6, and Wi-Fi 6 is one of those, you know, top end access, Wi-Fi access that we have. So we are certain and assured of, you know, efficient and effective connectivity at the airport.
The Kampala City Council Authority Executive Director, Dorothy Kisaka, highlighted that the city will undergo a major phase uplift, which will include the construction and renovation of some roads, eviction of all those illegally operating from the roadsides, demolition of all illegal structures, including eviction of street children, among others.
We are asking all Kampala residents to, in the spirit of our African culture of cleaning up when you're receiving visitors, let everybody deal with their frontages. This is painting and making sure the front of your trading space or housing is not congested. And we have teams on the roads that are supporting the clearing of the frontages.
The summits will run under the theme, Deepening Cooperation for Shared Global Affluence. Report by Jaliad Namwaya for the news.